JanBask training, learn and grow.
I am Prateek from JanBask, and in this session, let's take a look at AWS. Let's go through the agenda. In this session, we'll look at what is cloud, why cloud is important, what are the various cloud service models, what are the advantages when we are working on a cloud platform, what is Amazon, some background information about Amazon, AWS overview, and then we'll look at a small demo of AWS, how exactly we go about creating an AWS account and what are the services available. So let's start with what is cloud computing. Cloud computing is the on-demand delivery of compute power, database, storage applications, and other IT resources through a cloud services platform via the internet with pay-as-you-go pricing. Cloud computing provides a simple way to access servers, storage, databases, and a broad set of application services over the internet. So instead of maintaining all these infrastructure components in your local environment, you can access all of these components over the internet and make use of them as per your demand. A cloud services platform such as Amazon Web Services owns and maintains the network connected hardware required for these application services, while you provision and use what you need via a web application. Why do we need a cloud? We see that there are a large number of businesses currently moving to the cloud. It's because cloud computing increases efficiency, helps improve cash flow, and offers many other benefits such as high flexibility, low cost disaster recovery, easy upgradability for the software. We can work from anywhere when our software is hosted on a cloud platform. It provides inbuilt facilities such as security, scalability, and storage space. So for these reasons, more and more organizations and work is migrating to the cloud services. What are the various cloud service models? Well, we have infrastructure as a service, platform as a service, and software as a service. So these are abbreviated as IaaS, PaaS, and SaaS. Some of the major cloud service providers are Amazon, which provides the AWS platform, which is our focus for this session. Then Google provides GCP, which is the Google Cloud Platform. Microsoft provides Azure. IBM gives us Bluemix. And Red Hat provided the OpenShift platform. Some of the advantages involved are there is no local infrastructure setup required, lower management and administrative overhead, pay per use, so running cost can be optimized, customized options tailored to an individual requirement, so you can decide which services are relevant for you and you can make use of only those services and in turn pay only for the services that you are actually using. It provides ready-made tools for deployment and monitoring, so it makes management of the entire infrastructure much easier. Now we come to Amazon. Since the focus of this session is AWS, let's see some information about Amazon as a company. It was founded in July 1994 by Jeff Bezos. It is headquartered in Seattle. Areas of operation include cloud computing, consumer electronics, electronic commerce. Our focus for the purpose of this presentation is the cloud computing platform from Amazon, which is the Amazon Web Services. Now, what is AWS? It is an Amazon subsidiary. It provides on-demand cloud computing platform. It was launched in 2002. It comprised of 90 cloud services in 2017, and this number continues to grow. Some of the examples of the services provided by AWS are the Elastic Compute Cloud, which is abbreviated as EC2, the storage platform, which is S3, Simple Queuing Service, SQS, and many, many more. So we'll look at the list of these services when we do the actual demo. AWS services span domains such as computing, storage, networking, database, analytics, machine learning, developer tools, Internet of Things, blockchain, games, and several others. Now let's take a brief look at what AWS is like. So in order to use AWS services, first we need to create an AWS account. In order to do that, we bring up the aws.amazon.com web page. There we see this red button, which is for creating an AWS account. Now you can click on this red button. It will ask you for certain information related to your account. Say, for example, details about your user ID, password. Then in the next step, it will ask you for your card information. So as we know that AWS is a paid platform. So when we are making use of the services within this platform, we are charged. And this charge is levied on the credit card information that we provide in this particular screen. So once you provide all the information and submit, your account will get created. In my case, I already have an account, so I'll just bring up the management console. So this is what your management console looks like. Now, if you are not actually signed in, it will prompt you for a user ID and password, and then you can enter into the management console screen. As we discussed earlier, there are a lot of services provided by AWS, and here you can see a list of all the available services. For example, in compute, you have EC2, which is the Elastic Compute environment. Then you have LightSail, which is a lightweight version of your compute environment. Then lot of other services, say Lambda. Lambda is for exposing Lambda function. Then under the storage subsection, we have S3. Which is used for storing information in S3 buckets. Then we have Storage Gateway, S3 Glacier. In the database segment, we have RDS, which provides for relational data services. We also have several other options such as DocumentDB, DynamoDB, Neptune. These provide both relational as well as NoSQL database storage platforms. So it's very intuitive to go through all the available services. What are the features which are provided by AWS? As you can see, it's a very comprehensive listing. You have services available for machine learning, analytics, business applications, games, AR and VR, Internet of Things. So virtually most facets of software components are included within the AWS offerings. Here there are certain videos also which enable you to take a look at how to go about launching these services. So you can see that there are tutorials for building websites, storage, databases, etc. So it's quite instructive to see some of these videos when we are starting off with AWS. Now let's take a look at Elastic Compute Cloud. That was the first service that we saw on the management console. So EC2 provides a compute platform when we are using AWS. It provides secure and resizable compute capacity in the cloud. AWS guarantees 99.99% availability for this compute platform. It provides support for multiple OS types. Windows, Linux, and several other OSs are available when you are creating your EC2 environment. There are multiple memory, CPU, storage options for creating your EC2 instances. These can be administered using the management console, which we just saw, or you can also manage, configure it using command line interface and also APIs which are exposed by Amazon. For storage, we can use S3. S3 stands for Simple Storage Service. It is the object storage service of AWS. It provides 11 nines durability, so that's a pretty high figure. It enables secured access to data, It supports data query, data selection, archival, and disaster recovery. The administrative interfaces again include the management console, command line interface, and also the Amazon APIs. Within the database segment, we saw a number of options. Let's look at some of the relevant options. AWS provides support for both relational and NoSQL database service. Examples include AWS RDS, which is the relational database service, Aurora, which again is a relational database service, DynamoDB provides NoSQL database service, Redshift is a data warehouse platform, Elastic Cache is an in-memory data cache service, and Neptune is a graph database. So all flavors of databases are made available via AWS services. We can select the relevant database platform based on our application requirement and our architecture. From a networking standpoint, AWS makes use of VPC, which is a virtual private cloud. It represents a logically isolated AWS segment. It enables launching AWS resources such as web server, application server, databases, etc., with customized network configuration. This again can be created using the AWS management console, which we saw some time back. It supports up to 200 subnets per VPC. So you can create as many as 200 subnets per virtual private cloud. It can be connected securely to corporate local data center over VPN. So it essentially provides you an extension to your local data center by making use of infrastructure which is available as part of Amazon Cloud offering. So in order to summarize, we have seen that AWS provides the infrastructure and services for hosting various components which are made use of by a typical application developer or by a typical service provider. We saw the large number of services which are exposed by AWS. Some of those include EC2, which is for instantiating compute resources. Then we saw S3, which provides storage components. So your data can be stored in S3 buckets. Then we saw the relational data services which are provided. These include both the relational as well as graph-oriented NoSQL data stores and so on. So all flavors of databases are made available. Then from a networking standpoint, we looked at virtual private cloud, which essentially allows us to use the cloud services as an extension of our local data center. So with this, we come to the conclusion of our introduction to AWS. In the subsequent lessons, we will be looking at these different services in more detail. So look forward to seeing you as we progress through the course. Thank you.
JanBask training. Learn and grow.